I am looking very forward to the weekend, which has just begun, and I'm having a blast here. The people are great. The people that come to it are great. Yes, I'm having fun.
Obviously, there's so many different types of fans of all the different genres here this weekend. What do you think that the zombie genre has that gives it such a unique and timeless global appeal?
I think there's this... People are thinking of the world ending, apocalypse. So a lot of people want to fantasize about all the world starting again. You know, just being wiped out and having a little adventure, fighting zombies, just being strong. And I think that is the appeal of it. I don't know for sure. I guess it's different with everyone, but that's what I hear a lot. I think it has the strongest impact on people because nobody knows what lies beyond us. You know, there's some people that believe in God, some people that believe in reincarnation, some people that that's it. I think that being a zombie kind of like, it doesn't affect everyone. It's just kind of like that's what happens. So I think it's like not breaking, like not saying you're in hell or you're in, you know, this place. I think living on is what is attractive to it. And also, depending on the fast or slow, having some action, you know, fighting them.
If you were to be in a zombie apocalypse, would you become a hero and try and save as many people as possible, or make your own stronghold and be more of a villain?
Oh, that's a good question. I think I would probably... If I was in one, I would probably try to save people and animals. A lot of animals, I'd save. And I would then find a safe place where we could all be. That's what I'd like to do. Like kick ass and have fun.
And if you got bitten by a zombie, would you want the people that you saved to put you out straight away or wait until you turned into a zombie before?
Oh, boy.
Dispatching.
I think the minute I changed into a zombie, because being a human and the fear of, you know, something dying would be scary. So, like, right when I changed, I'd like them to, boom, get me.
Based off against pretty much every kind of horror villain monster in films to date, including werewolves quite recently in Bon Hill Road.
Yes.
What one haven't you faced off that you would be quite interested to be part of?
Oh, that's an interesting one, too. I think kind of a fairy tale one. I mean, I've done, like, the werewolves, the zombies, the demons. So something like a fairy tale, like, I'm trying to think, Little Red Riding Hood, even though that's a wolf, or something in the nursery line. Yeah. I don't think a dragon. I don't want to do a dragon. Matthew McConaughey did a dragon, so I'm going to pass on that. I like vampires. I've actually never, let me think. I don't think I've done a vampire film. So I'd like to fight a vampire and just, especially the vampire that is in Penny Dreadful that got away. I am so mad about that because I don't know how many of you, you know, see Penny Dreadful or used to watch it, but I was so upset at the ending when he got away and everybody else didn't. I was very upset about that. So I'd like to go after that guy and knock him out.
Son of the Living Dead, at the time, could you have ever envisioned it would become such a cult phenomenon and that it'd have such a hardcore fan base that it does to date?
I'm totally shocked by the base, the horror base that it is like become, and it's a cult film. When we did it, we didn't think anything of it. We thought we were doing another horror film, and of course you don't see other actors doing their other things sometimes because you aren't in scenes with them. So we just thought, okay, we're doing a horror movie and it'll be out. you know, come and go. And that's when, because I loved horror myself, but then I discovered that there's a lot more people that love it too, which was great because I could meet them. So, but no way did I think it was going to be a cult classic and last this long. And I'm very sad because, you know, yesterday I was informed that James Caron died. And he was like a driving force because he was always positive, always upbeat. And he kind of like inspired you just to do more and be a better person too.
Are there particular memories that stand out most powerfully for you that make you smile the most, laugh the most, cry the most?
In Return of the Living Dead? Oh, my. Oh, I get... Okay, in the movie, when James Caron goes to the cremation place and he takes his ring off and they're playing that music, burn, you know? I don't know, that gets me every time. I get just like really like, oh, God, you know, because it's just like so horrible. And, you know, he's like obviously a very happy married man and he just does that. It's sad to me. What stands out is the amazing effects they got, practical effects they did, like the woman, the split woman on the table. It's like, how did they do it? It's like an amazing thing. It's not CGI or anything. And also just when I was in the mud and all the zombies were attacking me, I was very scared because extras tend to be a little overzealous. And I was like, oh my God, everybody's gonna wanna be in the front and, you know, be seen. And I'm like, I'm gonna like drown. So I was a little afraid of that a bit. And then also when I was buried for the resurrection, I had to like get down like in a yoga pose. And these people they actually buried me. They were taking shovels and burying me, and I couldn't breathe. And I had to kind of count in my head because they had to cue the rain machines, sound, and then action, and I couldn't hear. So I had to, like, in my head think, okay, when should I come up? Because I didn't want to do it again. And I didn't want to slip on the mud, so I'm like, okay, I've got to do it one time. So that was kind of freaky. I'm proud of Trash, and I'm proud of Spider in Sorority Babes and the Slimeball Bowlerama, which I think is called The Imp here. It was. It used to be called The Imp. I don't know if they've changed it or not, but years ago I went on a little tour with it, and it's just such a fun part. It was a part that I got to keep my clothes on. I didn't have a shower scene, you know, and I got to be the tough girl, which I'm kind of reenacting. A few months ago, there's a movie coming out called Clownado, and I kind of bring back that character. So it's interesting. Like, what would she do if she, you know, when she grows up?